Hello, welcome to the Fiscal Policy chapter, the last chapter for this MBA 200 class. Similar to the previous chapter, this one doesn't have a number because it's not contained in your textbook. So, just like monetary policy, the MBA program requires that you learn the basics of fiscal policy. So, we are going to achieve this by using the free online material available at amosweb.com. So please check the for further study clips so you can learn how to navigate to this online material. So let's start. Basically, fiscal policy is the control over government spending and taxes by a central government, which is used to stabilize the business cycle, reduce unemployment and inflation, and promote economic growth. In the United States, fiscal policy is primarily under the control of the federal government. However, state and local governments also undertake fiscal policy to stabilize their local economies. For example, they levy tax, state income taxes, or issue bonds for development purposes, and other examples. The main goals of fiscal policy are to stabilize the business cycle, reduce unemployment and inflation, and promote economic growth. And in principle, these goals are supposed to be achieved in a coordinated effort with the central bank, which is in charge of monetary policy. Now, the government has three main tools to achieve these goals. Number one, expenditures by the government sector, particularly the federal government, on final goods and services. And these are called government purchases, which includes purchases and expenditures on public schools, the military, the highway system, etc. Number two, taxes, which are involuntary payments from the household and corporate sectors to the government sector. And number three, transfer payments, which are essentially gifts made to the household sector. Notice that different from government purchases, these payments, transfer payments, are not made in exchange for goods and services. And of course, these include, for example, the food stamps, social security, unemployment compensation, and other welfare payments. Now, one key question is to understand how changes in the fiscal policy affect the economy. The answer depends on whether the goal is to stimulate or, again, to put the brakes to the economy to make sure it doesn't grow too fast. The fiscal policy intended to stimulate the economy, which is basically correcting the problems of a business cycle contraction, is called expansionary policy and includes any combination of an increase in government purchases, a decrease in taxes, or an increase in transfer payments. The fiscal policy intended to restrain the economy and therefore correcting the problems of a business cycle expansion is called contractionary policy and includes any combination of a decrease in government purchases, an increase in taxes, or a decrease in transfer payments. Now, policy lags are a very important concept to grasp, and they apply to both fiscal and monetary policy. Although I didn't discuss this in the monetary policy lecture, these lags, they do apply to both fiscal and monetary policy. Normally, economists consider four policy lags contained in this slide: the recognition lag, the decision lag, the implementation lag, and the impact lag. The importance of lags lays on the fact that changing the course of the economy takes time, even when the right diagnostic has been made and the right policy mix has been chosen. In other words, the effects of fiscal and or monetary policy changes take time to be seen and to be felt in the economy. This is why sometimes we wonder why, right after the Federal Reserve, say, increases or decreases the interest rate, or after governments decrease or increase taxes, we don't see an immediate change. Well, that's because any or all of these lags are having an impact. Okay, once again, we cannot finish even a brief discussion of fiscal policy without mentioning its linkages to politics. As you can see in this slide, in general, conservatives tend to prefer contractionary fiscal policy. This keeps inflation rates down, even though higher unemployment might result. In contrast, liberals tend to prefer expansionary fiscal policy. This ensures lower unemployment rates, even though higher inflation rates might result. And once again, since this is a managerial econ class, not political economy, I am going to leave it here. But the politics of fiscal policy is another very interesting subject matter within economics. Finally, it is important to mention the very key relation between monetary and fiscal policy. When the federal government spends more than it collects in taxes, then the government faces a balanced deficit. This deficit is paid for by borrowing from the public, which is made possible through issuing treasury securities. And this is why US treasury securities take center stage in the conduction of open market operations. As discussed before, the Fed exchanges bank reserves and treasury securities as the primary means of controlling the money supply. And treasury securities are issued by the US Department of Treasury to raise the funds needed to finance the federal deficit. I'm going to explain this in the for further study clips, so make sure you stop by that section. Okay, this concludes the chapter, and this is the last lecture for this course.